Women in Politics, under their umbrella body of the Inter-Party Women Platform, have re-echoed a call to opposition political parties to embrace dialogue with the ruling NRM party. The women believe that this will be the only way for the country to have a peaceful transition, but most importantly, avert ugly scenarios like what is happening in Sudan, where two warring leaders failed to agree.
Uganda is seated on a time bomb. The moment we do not think that dialogue is the first priority to rebuild this country, we are done. Otherwise, since time immemorial from independence, Uganda has gotten leaders. And from there, we have been changing leadership through bloodshed. Why should we continue like that after all this period? I think having a dialogue in this country is really very critical. And with the dialogue, it's not about talking with whoever you agree with. No. Actually, the biggest dialogue should happen with whoever you do not agree with, such that you get a common position. And this common position, by the way, it is not a win-lose. It is a win-win.
Inter-Party Women Platform involves women leaders from the 9 political parties, including NRM, Alliance for National Transformation, DP, FDC, JEMA, PPP, among others. The women leaders also expressed the need for presidents within the African continent to move quickly and intervene in the ongoing war in Sudan.
Security throughout the continent becomes one of the most critical issues that must be addressed, because the moment security is not stable in any area, in any country, it means a lot of problems are going to happen throughout the region. That means for the issue of leaders coming together, it is late overdue. It is one of the best solutions that can be given out to ensure that the issue of Sudan is solved amicably.
I hope that Uganda can learn from Sudan, learn from even ourselves, because as she has said, since independence, we have been changing.
They have also condemned police brutality on women members of parliament.
Condemn the acts of police, not only police, but also the other security forces. We've seen so many women have been brutal, not only members of parliament. You see these workers, the so-called Watembe. They are also being brutal by KCCA security agencies. And we are saying enough is enough. As women, we are saying we should have peace.
On 27th of last month, 11 women MPs clad in black attempted to march from Parliamentary Avenue to the office of the Minister of Internal Affairs to deliver their petition on dissatisfaction over continued blockage of female opposition MPs from holding post-Women's Day celebrations in their constituencies. However, police brutally arrested them. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.